In the last lecture, I explained about the wave nature of electromagnetic radiation. I already told you electromagnetic radiation is having dual nature, wave nature, particle nature. Next, last class I explained about wave nature. Now let us see about particle nature of electromagnetic radiation. Particle nature of electromagnetic radiation was explained by two main theories. One is black body radiation, second one is photoelectric effect. These two theories will explain about particle nature of electromagnetic radiation. Let us see about the black body radiation. Black body radiation nothing but radiation emitted by black body is black body radiation. Okay, so radiation emitted by black body. Radiation emitted by black body is said to be black body radiation. Then what is black body? Black body is an ideal body which is perfect absorber and perfect emitter. Means it can absorb all types of frequencies and emit all types of frequencies. So I can write here black body is a perfect absorber and perfect emitter. It can absorb total frequencies of radiation. And it is a black body is ideal body. Black body is an ideal body. There is no real black bodies in the universe. So for example, we can say black bodies, a simple example I can say black holes. Stephen Hawking explained about black holes. Black holes, due to high gravity, they can able to absorb all types of frequencies, so it appears as black. So whatever the color you are seeing, this is transmitting color. Mean it can absorb some amount of frequencies and emit different types of frequencies. But black body, it won't absorb a small amount. It absorbs all types of frequencies with it. Okay, that's why I written here perfect absorber and perfect emitter. Suppose let us take it is a black body. It is a black body and heating at T1 temperature. If I draw the graph between wavelength and intensity. Wavelength and intensity. On heating at T1 temperature, black body will emit certain radiations. Will emit radiation. Black body on heating at certain T1 temperature, it emit radiations. For that radiation, if you calculate the intensity and wavelength, you can observe the graph like this. The intensity at T1 temperature is, let us take this is the wavelength. This is, let us take lambda 1 at T1 temperature. Again, on increasing temperature, T1 to T2. T2 temperature is more compared to T1. Okay, when increasing temperature from T1 to T2, it gives the another curve like this. The intensity will be like this. It is lambda 2. So further increasing temperature, we had imagined that T3 is greater than T2, then T1. T3 is the highest temperature here. On heating at highest temperature, we can observe the intensity curve like this. The peak will be shifted here. So if you observe the lambda values, the T3 temperature will give lambda 3. At T2, I will get the lambda 2. At T1 temperature, lambda 1. If I observe the wavelength of those peak method will hear intensity peak at T1 temperature having wavelength lambda 1. Similarly, for T3, lambda 3, T2, lambda 2. On heating to higher temperature from T1 to T3 and increasing higher temperature, those intensity curves shifted to the lower wavelengths. Intensity curves shifted to the lower wavelengths. Here, lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3. Which is having higher wavelength here? Lambda 1. So, they are shifted to lower wavelength. This is lower wavelength. Lower wavelength. and this is T1 temperature, low temperature, it is giving the high wavelength. Okay, what we mean, we have to understand here, at higher temperatures, intensity shift to lower wavelengths, peak of intensity, lower wavelengths. Okay, so this way we can explain the black body radiation. Simple concept, black body is an ideal body which is a perfect absorber, perfect emitter, and radiation emitted by the black body is said to be black body radiation. On heating black body at different temperature, T1, T2, T3, different temperatures, from T1 lower temperature to T3 higher temperature, it emits a different types of radiations having different wavelengths. So on increasing temperature, the radiation emitted by the black body shifted to the lower wavelengths, mean they transferred to the lower wavelengths like visible radiations. Okay, so this is all about the black body radiation, but classical physics failed to explain this. Classical physics explained that on heating we are getting the curve like this, it is shifting to infinity intensity. This is the classical theory. Classical theory could not explain, but this is the particle nature. Particle nature of this was explained effectively by the black body radiation. Of course, black body radiation was successfully explained by the particle nature of electromagnetic radiation. So in extent to this, in continuation of the black body radiation, actually black body radiation was explained by the Max Planck. Based on this black body radiation, he further explained very important theory called as Planck's quantum theory. Planck's quantum theory explains about the again particle nature. Whatever the radiation which is coming out from the black body or any object is not continuous. It won't emit radiation continuously. It emits radiation discontinuous form. So that discontinuous form is said to be quantum. Let us see what is Planck's quantum theory. Planck's quantum theory. If I take any one object, on heating this object, this every atom contains some particles. So due to vibration of those particles, they can absorb or emit the radiation. Either absorption or emission of radiation by an object is due to vibration of charged particle. So due to vibration of charged particle, radiation is emitted or absorbed due to vibration of charged particle in a body, in object. Due to vibration of charged particle in object, radiation is emitted or absorbed. So this emission or absorption is not continuous, but it is in discontinuous form. Actually, wave nature of electromagnetic explains that. So this is the wave nature of electromagnetic radiation. It says that radiation is, which is coming from any one source, is always emitted in the form of wave. But quantum theory explaining that radiation emitted by the black body is small packets of energy. This is small packets of energy, small packets of electromagnetic radiation. This is we are calling as particle energy. You see the difference. This is wave nature and this is particle nature. Wave nature, particle nature, both are different. Okay, so this is the classical theory, this is the Planck's theory or particle nature of electromagnetic radiation. So according to Planck quantum theory, radiation emission or absorption, the radiation emitted by the body or absorption by the body is not continuous. It won't emit continuously, it won't absorb continuously. But how it can absorb or emit? In the form of discontinuous form. What is discontinuous form? A small packets of energy. Okay, that small packet, each packet represents some energy. Each packet associated with a small amount of energy. That energy associated with each packet is called as quantum. So I write it here. Each small packet associated with some energy. That energy is called as quantum. What is quantum? Electromagnetic radiation, which is associated with a small amount of energy in the form of small packets, is known as quantum. Remember this quantum is a discontinuous form. It won't emit continuously. Discontinuously, it keep on emitting. So, what is the energy of this quantum? To understand the energy of quantum, he has given the relation between the energy and frequency. So, that relation I can write here. So, let me once again explain here. Planck quantum theory explained about particle nature. Any one body on heating, it emit energy. Or it, even if supply heat, it absorb energy. So that absorption or emission is due to the vibration of charged particle. Due to vibration of charged particle of an object, it can emit or absorbs. This emission or absorption is not continuous, but in the form of discontinuous form. This discontinuous form nothing but each in the form of particle nature. This is a wave nature, this is a particle nature. Now particle nature nothing but here, I am telling here, whatever the energy emitted by the object is in small packets of energy, small packets. So each packet represents some amount of energy, that is said to be quantum. So what is energy? Energy of the each quantum energy of quantum is directly proportional to frequency. Energy is directly proportional to frequency. I can write here, E is directly proportional to U. Energy of quantum directly proportional to frequency. So, proportional replaced by constant, E is equal to H nu. This is a relation, important relation. This H nu is said to be quantum. Is said to be quantum of energy. Here I can write H is equal to Planck's constant. Planck's constant. The value is 6.626 into 10 power minus 34 joule second, or 6.626 into 10 power minus 27 earth second. This is the Planck's constant. And we know nu is equal to frequency. Nu is equal to frequency. Okay, when you know the frequency of those radiation, then we can easily find out the energy of that radiation. Here I can use one more term, that is quantum of visible radiation. Quantum of visible light is called photon. Quantum of visible light is said to be photon. Both are same. But photon particularly for visible light. This is the same formula is equal to H nu we can write. If light contains n photon, then energy what I can write here? If it contains one photon, I can write one H nu. If it contains n photons, I can write n h nu. This is the formula. So I can write here energy is always integral multiples of photon. Energy of quantum is always integral multiples of h nu. So I can write here this energy is quantized. Energy is quantized. Where n is equal to integer means what I will be quantized here? Either absorption of energy or emission of energy is always in the form of 1 h nu, 2 h nu, 3 h nu, 4 h nu, etc. It won't absorb in between them. Radiation cannot be emitted as 0.5 h nu. It won't emit as 3 by 2 h nu. Or it won't absorb. Either absorption or emission is always in the form of 1 h nu, 2 h nu, 3 h nu, 4 h nu. That type of fixed amount of energy. H nu is the fixed. So that fixed amount of energy is said to be quantized. That property is said to be quantized. That energy may be quantized. In Bohr theory, it is angular momentum is quantized. Quantized nothing but the property which contains a fixed value. So here, energy of the Planck, according to Planck quantum, the energy of photon or energy of quantum is said to be quantized. Okay, so this is Planck's quantum theory and this is important relations. E is equal to h nu or E is equal to n h nu. So this is a quantum or photon. This is integral multiples of h nu. Okay, so this is all about the black body radiation, Planck's quantum theory. So this first explains about the particle nature of electromagnetic radiations. Next lecture, I will explain about the another theory which is explained by Einstein, that is photoelectric effect.